You don't work to get to heaven, but what you do for the Lord, He is certainly going to be faithful to reward you. I've seen many people when He's taken me up to the throne room receiving their rewards, and they're so undone because they never understood what He meant when He said that. He gives you things like His own songs that have never been sung even in heaven. And when He opens this treasure box to give it to you, it begins to wind around you like a garment. It's called garments of praise. See, there are many things mentioned in the Word, but we don't have, because we have our human minds we're thinking with. And it says, eyes not seen, and you haven't understood really or thought in your mind what God has for you. But there are literal garments of praise, and those garments of praise play one of His songs that He sings Himself but hasn't been sung in heaven. And when you walk around heaven and you wear that garment, everywhere you go, you hear the Father singing off of you. And people are undone. They'll just fall out even in heaven. Not because of you, but because of what you're wearing. There's a place in heaven called Passionate Paradise, and it's all about worship. It's for those who worship Him in spirit and in truth. And it's one of your rewards for doing that on earth. And you'll be taken there. Usually the Father will grab a band of that rainbow that comes from Him, and He'll throw it out of the throne room, and you see it going over heaven looking for that one person who's just come home, and it will wrap itself. Everyone gets undone. You are never going to stop being undone when you go to heaven. Now, people who've been living there know what this person is about to experience. They don't have a clue. He always surprises you, and then it will literally catch you up, and you ride with that band of the color back to where the Father is, and then He takes you to this place called Passionate Paradise. And they're beautiful. There's beautiful mountains, but they don't look like normal mountains here. They're like really high and kind of narrow, and these mountains are built on praise. And as they go and praise there, it literally builds something of substance. Because your praise has substance in heaven. Even now when we worshiped here today, there were angels here putting canvas under the feet of those who were dancing. And as they danced, they were creating a masterpiece of their love for the Lord. See, this is what happens when you can see. People think seers are weird, spooky things. No, it's a beautiful thing. I know what happens when you worship. I know what happens in the spirit realm. Remember, that's where our authority is. Heaven is a spiritual place, but it is a literal place. You live a real life. You can feel your body, touch yourself. You eat the food. It tastes amazing. There's no weight gain or food allergies in heaven. That's why it's called heaven. But this beautiful, beautiful place, you're taken there, and then the Lord meets you there, and he's continually talking to you about what He experienced in heaven while you were on the earth worshiping Him. You get so undone. People think you don't cry in heaven. You weep with tears of joy. Now, at the very end of everything, when He wipes away all tears, that's not in heaven, but there are no tears of grief. There's no tears of sadness in heaven. There's only tears of joy in the fact that you're getting so overwhelmed and undone by the beauty and the generosity and the love of the Father and the Son. And so He begins to tell you all these times that meant so much to Him. When you were going through things and you could have chosen to be angry at God, or you could have just, you know, just given up, but instead you worshiped Him. That is so powerful. The most powerful thing you can do in your worst day is look up and worship God. I've been in the throne room where He opened the throne room floor, and everyone in there could witness someone on the earth doing that. And the most beautiful aromas would ascend with that praise. And it created an incense in the throne room that you literally could smell. Your praise is wonderful. It is beautiful. It's one of the number one ways to glorify God. Another one is to love people. But Jesus takes you to this place, and a lot of people come there wearing these garments of praise that God had given them. Whitney Houston has one. Got it real quiet. I was traveling and speaking when she passed away, and when someone said to me, "Did you hear Whitney Houston pass?" The Holy Spirit said, "In this ear right here, she sang her own salvation." And I didn't know anything that had happened in her life. I just knew that if the Holy Spirit said that. And then when I was sitting on the front row to go and speak, he caught me up to heaven and I saw her. This is about a week after she had passed. She was at the throne with the Father. And he was literally giving her, it's the first time I'd seen when he was giving her a garment of praise. He said, "Because you were willing to use your gift on the earth for me, and because you gave yourself back to me," he said, "I'm giving you one of my own personal songs that's never been sung in heaven." I was totally undone. And Whitney looked like she was in her 20s. And she was glowing with the glory of God. And I saw this garnet-colored music. In heaven, you see music. You don't just hear it and feel it. You literally can see music in heaven. And I heard and saw this song coming out of this beautiful little treasure chest, and it began to wrap itself around her, and she was just weeping with tears of joy. And he said, "Now move your hand," and she moved her hand, and that song began to play in the throne room. God's voice just coming, singing off of this garment that she was wearing, and she was totally undone. She was just shaking. And the Father said, "When you get to your mansion, go look in your treasure room, because there's more there waiting for you." So your heart and mind cannot conceive the goodness of God. And then I found out later that the last night of her life, she was out at a club with her friends. And everybody was yelling at her to sing. Wherever she was, people wanted her to sing. And she kept saying, "I don't want to. I don't feel good. I don't want to do that." And they said, "Please, please, please." So finally she said, "Well, I'll sing one song." And she stood up and sang with everything in her, all her hurt, all the stuff that she was in her life that was devastating her life, left her as she's saying, "Yes, Jesus loves me." And it was witnessed by everybody in that club. Heard her sing it in a way she had never sang it before. And in that moment that she did that, she was giving herself back to Jesus. So please don't judge people that you don't know how God got them. Amen. She gave herself back. So there are garments of praise in this beautiful place. The Lord brings them there, and you actually get to ascend these beautiful high places in heaven, and you begin to sing with the garment that you're wearing. You get to sing that song that God gave you, and people stop in heaven because they hear this beautiful song coming and playing all over heaven, and they know somebody was taken to passionate paradise. It's the high place in heaven. Isn't that beautiful?